All right. Joining me on the line now is Wendy Schugar-Martin. I actually met her not too long ago at a county commission meeting. Now, Wendy used to volunteer at the same shelter where I volunteer every weekend here in Broward County, Florida, in Fort Lauderdale. It's the Broward County Animal Care and Adoption Center. But Wendy is a woman after my own heart because she spoke out and basically blew the whistle on some of the conditions there, trying to make things better for the animals that, I don't want to speak for you, Wendy. Were you actually fired as a volunteer?
I was the first volunteer that was fired by Lorelei Cohn, because I was very vocal and trying to help her, but when she stopped returning my phone calls and stopped asking for my help, I felt that my only opportunity as an advocate for the animals was to speak out. And once I did start speaking out, they decided that they needed to try to quiet me.
Uh-huh.
Unfortunately for them, it only made me a little louder.
And just to let people know what's going on, Lorelei Combs, who you mentioned, was the executive director of the shelter who was brought in maybe 2 years ago, and she just thankfully tendered her resignation. Hopefully a search will be on for a competent director of the shelter once all this craziness blows over. Now, I wish they would have started the search already. I don't think they've even posted the job yet, which is a topic that needs to be addressed, but let's save that for another day because we have more pressing concerns at hand, which right now is the coronavirus, and what's happening around the country is all what they're calling non-essential businesses are being shut down. The entire state of California last night was put on a mandatory shelter-at-home program, so it's just a matter of time before it happens here. Miami-Dade County, which is just south of us here in Broward, also has all non-essential businesses closed as of 9 p.m. last night, and the governor this morning said Broward County, where we are, and Palm Beach County are next. And so my concern is that they're going to close the animal shelters. As of right now, they're still slated to be open tomorrow, which is Saturday. I volunteer there usually on Sundays, but for the last couple of weeks, I'm going both days, knowing that we're on a very tight time frame. And as I've been, you know, pleading here on my show and on social media, that a number of things. One is, please help these animals, because I don't even want to think about what's going to happen when they do shut the shelters. More and more are being turned in every day. At the Broward shelter alone, yesterday there were 23 animals brought in, and I'm sure the adoptions and the fosters weren't even close to that level. And once they close the doors to the public, that's it. The adoptions and the fosters will end, except Wendy Schugar-Martin, you have an idea to help, right?
Absolutely. I think that with every crisis, there's always an opportunity. And there's an opportunity for people to really shine and do what they can within their power. And so we really think that there's an opportunity for families who are relegated to being at home, families whose the adults in the family are working from their homes, children who are home from school doing schoolwork. We think that this is such an important opportunity for them to help some of these homeless pets. Now, I think that, you know, bringing a pet into your home can be a difficult decision, but when you foster a pet, where you just take them out of the shelter for this short period of time, when you know you're going to be home, right? You're not going out on vacation.
Yep.
You're not traveling. You're not going to restaurants and wondering how the animal will do by themselves at home while people are at school during the day. Everyone is around to help support this animal. What a great opportunity to relieve some of the pressure, because although I am not anticipating the shelter will necessarily be closed,
I think,
though, that they will start, if volunteers haven't stopped coming in for fear,
mm-hmm.
volunteers will be told not to come into the shelter, and it'll be left on our staff, who is already overwhelmed. So here's this great opportunity for us to relieve some of that strain and stress on the staff that is at the shelter by taking some of these animals into their homes. So we are developing a program here in Broward, particularly, and we're using some of the ideas that we've seen around the country. We've seen some of these drive-through adoptions and foster opportunities. We've seen other pleas from shelters. And we're building a program with our local resources that will provide supplies like food, bowls, leashes, collars for mm-hmm. the pets that are going to go home, and an easy way for them to pick and choose. They'll fill out a quick questionnaire about any other pets in their home. They'll get a list of animals that are ready to leave the building, spayed, neutered, up to date on shots, and whether or not that animal does well with other dogs, dogs and cats, things like that, so that people can basically pull up, a staff member or a volunteer can pull that animal out of the shelter, bring it to their car, load food and supplies into their car, and send that shelter pet home on a vacation with a shelter at home family.
What a great idea. So this is something that you are proposing to the management at the Broward County Animal Care and Adoption Center. We don't know if they're going to take you up on it, but you're doing all the legwork in advance, giving them a solution to what looks like it could be a huge problem. And it's something that people listening around the country can do wherever they are as well.
Well, absolutely. So we're building this program. I'm putting together in my other hat that I wear as a work for the thing that pays the bills is I do a lot of project development. So for me, I'm putting together a project plan. Anyone can reach out to me and I'll be happy to share the project plan. There is no proprietary information in it. I hope that other community resources around the country are able to work with their local shelters to help move these animals out. I think it creates less stress on everyone, right? The shelter pets who won't get enough attention, the families who are home. I think a great aspect is seniors in your community.
Yes.
Seniors who can't go out into their normal lives where maybe they are playing Mahjong mm-hmm. or visiting with friends. This is an opportunity for them to have some social interaction with a pet in their home so that they can have purpose during this quarantining period when we're protecting our seniors. And so we hope that they will look at the entire community, not just young families, not just seniors, but singles who are working at home, who maybe they would like to have a little friend. They're not able to go out to the nightclubs and bars and do things, but every day people can take a dog for a walk or be soothed by a gentle feline purring next to them. these are the opportunities that things like this, and where, in my experience, people really rise to the occasion
Absolutely.
To help out those where they can.
And, you know, I don't know what it is in other counties, but here in Broward County, high school kids, they need so many service hours to graduate. You get service hours, you earn service hours by fostering cats or dogs. And this is a perfect time. Give your kids some experience raising an animal. Again, they're home from school for at least the next few weeks, possibly longer. This is the perfect chance. Teach them responsibility. Let them know what it's like to take care of another being. I also think it's kitten season, if I'm not wrong, where we're going to have litters of kittens, and you can take home a litter of kittens that need to be hand fed. There's so many opportunities. And again, while the shelters are open this weekend, and I've made this offer on my show, on Facebook and on Twitter, I'm here in Broward County. I volunteer at the Broward County Animal Care and Adoption Center. I know so many of these dogs because I love them, and I get to know them, and I take pride in matching the perfect dog with the right people. And so if you're interested, but you're maybe a little nervous of wandering around a shelter, reach out to me. You can email me, Nicole@NicoleSandler.com. You can find me on Facebook or Twitter and send me a message. Tell me what you're looking for. I will find the right pet for you, give you a few choices, make an appointment to meet you at the shelter this weekend, introduce you to these few animals, and hopefully match you with one that's the perfect fit. My goal is to get as many of these animals out of the shelter while we still can, while, you know, it's still open to the public, while we're still allowed to volunteer there as possible, because who knows what the next few months are going to hold for us. So,
yes, most sincerely, the more people can come out now before a lot of these sheltered home orders come in.
Yes.
And while we proactively attend to our pets, you know, they need attention too. And we can't forget that there are opportunities for people to really contribute in a very, very simple way without a great burden on themselves. Because like I said, here in Broward, this program that we're putting together, anyone who fosters a pet will get free food and some supplies from our local resources, so that the families who are even having difficulty just putting together the funds to stock up on supplies for their own homes,
right,
won't feel this extra burden. Love costs nothing.
Right.
So love is something that we should all be giving away freely these days.
Without a doubt. And it'll you'll save the life of a pet, of an animal, of an innocent animal. But I promise you, it will also help you. There's nothing like, you know, when you're hunkered down for the night and you're binging some show on Netflix, to have this wonderful creature just loving you and cuddling up next to you. When you're living alone, thankfully I'm not these days, but when you are, that's a great comfort. And a lot of people are going to be alone for the next few months. So this, you know, it works in both directions. Now, Wendy Schugar-Martin, you said you've got this plan all worked out and you're willing to share it. If someone is interested in taking you up on that offer, where can they contact you?
They can send me an email. Mm-hmm. It's wendy@thefrecklesfreedomfund.com. They can find me on Facebook and Twitter. Both accounts are both public, so people can always see. And we will be posting links to all of the resources that we're putting out there, so anyone around the country can just yank them off the internet from us, or they can reach out to me directly and we'll help them work through any of the challenges that they might have. Some shelters, so for example, in Broward, they have in-house veterinary services, mm-hmm. so we can make sure the animals are spayed and neutered and up to date on vaccines. You know, some counties may need to find some of those resources because their facilities don't have those services, but we can help them. We have, our organization works around the country, and so we do have resources in various different areas, and we can put them in contact with some local resources for themselves too.
Oh, that's great. And I do want to mention, I meant to mention it when I intro'd you, but we just sort of leapt into the conversation. The Freckles yeah. Freedom Fund is an organization you co-founded. You're the executive director, and it's a rescue group for pit bulls and pitty mixes. Yes.
Yes, we are. We were founded by a group of women. We met each other in 2009 and saw a real need in bringing together resources, financial resources, to rescues who were on the ground doing rescue on a daily basis. And so we collaborate around the country in various different regions, providing as many resources as we can. So we have a southern contact, someone who's out west, someone who's in the northeast, and we help provide financial, sharing fosters or adopters, transportation, and other things that community partners with shelters need in order to help get the animals out of the shelters. And so our job is really facilitating moving pit bull type breed dogs. You know, it expands such an enormous category. Yes. Of any animal really that looks like a pit bull, which is, you know, sort
Tons
of a generic
them.
Term that I don't like to use really all the time anyway,
right.
But it's really meant to help move these harder to adopt because of the stereotypes and the stigmatism against, mm-hmm. you know, the negative stigmatisms against them. So, we, and, you know, here in Broward, we actually, our largest population are these square headed 60 pound brown dogs and gray dogs, I should say. So, we do a lot of work in this community in South Florida because of that. So we do work around the country. We do have a lot of resources around the country, a lot of contacts, and we're willing to share everything we have with everyone. Nothing is sacred to us. We think that the more animals we can find good homes for, the better. We propose helping just families to keep their animals in their homes, spay and neuter, medical resources for families, anything that we can do in order to keep them out of shelters or get them out of shelters.
That's awesome. So Wendy Schugar-Martin, again, the website for the Freckles Freedom Fund is thefrecklesfreedomfund.com. You can find her on Facebook, Twitter. I'll put all the links and everything on my blog where I post the day's show at NicoleSandler.com/the date, which today is 3-20-20. Wendy, thank you so much for the work you're doing, for this great idea to help these animals, even after we're inevitably told to hunker down in place. And I hope some people who, you know, maybe a little hesitant, take a leap of faith and realize that, you know, this works in both directions. It's something that great that you can do for another creature, and I promise it will help you as well. Wendy, I'm guessing I'll probably see you around in the next couple of days.
Because, I'm sure. Yeah, I'm sure.
Thank you again for the work you do.
Thank
it's
you
awesome.
For getting the work. Be safe out there.
Yes, you too. All right. Well, we'll talk soon.
All right.
Thanks again.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.